Hey, this is Flo and I'm back with another WWDC 2022 video for iOS 16 news, and in this episode we will have a look at widgets for your lock screen. It's actually super easy to add these, so let's jump right into it. This is an empty Xcode project, as always, nothing fancy here, and the first thing that you need to do is create a widget target. So let's go to File, New, Target, and search for Widget, the extension. And let's just call it Lockscreen Widgets. Let's hit finish. Let's activate the scheme so we can debug it right in the simulator. And then you will see that we have the Lockscreen Widgets file auto-generated for us. Now in here, this is a very basic WidgetKit implementation. We have our timeline provider, we have our timeline entry, then we have our actual widget struct with a preview for it. And then we also have our SwiftUI view in here, which is called Lockscreen Widgets Entry View. Now, in this video, I will not cover how WidgetKit works by itself. So I have an entire series about WidgetKit, which will be linked in the description. So you can just check that one out if you're not experienced with WidgetKit. And in this episode, we will actually not care about the timeline provider. We will not care about the timeline entry either. What we do care about is our view, our widget, and our previews. So first of all, the Lockscreen widgets are just three new widget families. So let's go ahead into our widget configuration and add the supported families modifier. And here we will just support the three new accessory families. So accessory inline, accessory circular, and accessory rectangular. So these are the three new lock screen widget sizes or widget families, basically. So now we've told the device that our widget extension only supports these three widgets. Next up, let's make sure we can see all three of them in our preview on the right-hand side. So first of all, let's give this preview a display name and let's call it inline. And then here for the family, let's say accessory inline, and then we can just copy paste that three times. So 1, 2, 3, one more for the circular and one more for the rectangular widget. And then let's also change the display names here. Okay. So now with these name changes, we can actually see the widget names here or the preview names here at the top bar here in our preview section. Next up, we want to display different things depending on the size classes. So we need to grab our widget family from the SwiftUI environment in our actual view. So for that, we will use the add environment property wrapper and the key path is just widget family. And let's make that a variable also called widget family. Then let's copy this text here and replace it with a switch on our widget family. Now, if we autocomplete this, there will be a lot of different cases here, which we don't actually all need. So let's get rid of all of the cases that we don't need. And let's just add a default case that says not implemented. While debugging, you might be able to get into this default case, but when the user actually has the app installed, this should never happen. Okay. So what do we want to display in these three different cases? I will just give you some examples so you can build your widgets on top of this. Once again, if you want more detail about how timeline providers work, how you can pass data to your widget and so on, you should have a look at the video description where my entire free WidgetKit course from last year is linked. It's pretty much still up to date, so there weren't many breaking changes this year, luckily, so you can just have a look there. But let's continue here. So I will show you a new view as well, which is the gauge. For the value, we will just pick an arbitrary number. This is just an example here. You would obviously get your data from somewhere, maybe not even display this type of view, but something custom, maybe an image, whatever it is. And then in here, we will just have a text label of our entry.date with a format of .datetime. And we only care about, let's say, the year, maybe. Okay, so let's copy that into the inline Family as well. And then for Rectangular, I would just put a text view directly inside here. So maybe something like this, just the entire date, for example. Now by itself, these gorgeous will not look very good. So we will have to customize them a bit. And there is a gorge style modifier, and we will just use accessory circular for the circular one. And I think I actually mixed them up. So for the inline one, we want our text, and for the rectangular one, we want the gorge. So now inline is just a plain text, and I will show you in a second on the simulator where each of these can be placed and how they will then look on the actual device. Now circular will be this little thing that you might already know from your Apple Watch complications. And then rectangular is a little bit larger, just like that. Let's go ahead and run this on an iPhone simulator so you can have a look at where each of these can be placed and how they will then look in reality. So you might run into this little error here, and I don't know why it happens, but when I run the widget extension again, it usually goes away. So now let's press Command L to lock the simulator, and then let's press the home button to unlock it again. So we're on the lock screen. Now here on the lock screen, you can just press and hold and tap customize. And then there are three different sections. At the top section, we can add this inline widget here. So it will just be appended to the date. And then at the bottom section, if we go into our lock screen test app, we can see our circular and our rectangular widgets. So let's add the circular on the left side and the rectangular on the right side. And now if we press done and go into the actual lock screen, you can see your widget in action. Now, once again, if you want to learn more about how WidgetKit actually works, how you can pass data to your view and actually display some useful information, then you should check out my free WidgetKit course linked in the description. This was just an intro to find out how to add widgets to the lock screen now in iOS 16. If you enjoy these videos and want to learn more about the new changes in iOS 16 and the new APIs, make sure to subscribe, leave a like, and then I will hopefully see you in the next video. Bye.